We are Detroit's college team.
Let's go, Titans.
Let's show Milwaukee the Detroit way.
To get off to better starts, I think the poor starts, but then we get a lift when we go to the bench. And our bench brings scoring, rebounding, plays, assists. We've just been getting a charge going to our bench. And we went in down 6 at half. And, we're concerned about their two-headed monster, two very good players that we're concerned about in Obi and Corey. And, to our guys' credit, though, we battled back and we never gave up. And we forced the overtime, just big play after big play. And here's two guys that that have really, really fought back and competed hard in practice and, had good all-around ball games for us. And, the three that Chris made was a big play. And then Jarod's effort and energy the first half, keeping us in it, was big. Where we go from here, we go to the Rising League season. We've been battled, tested. We played great competition. We're playing all over the country, all different kind of styles of play. I think we're getting closer to finding who we are, and it has to start, this week on the road at Wright State.
Going into Wright State, what are some of the things that you feel this team has to do better? I mean, as you mentioned, the slow starts, but you guys had your 5 or 12 from the free throw line. I know that's always a big thing with you, which is why you had these guys shoot so many free throws. So that was obviously a thing that hurt you. But what are some other things, besides that slow start that you just feel this team needs to do better going into Wright State and then just going into Horizon?
We've got to continue to, to defend. I mean, that's our thing. Before this, the previous four games, and we were holding our field goal defense was where it was tonight, around 40, 41. The difference was, on the free throw line. I mean, they was able to attack the basket with their best two players, and they got to the line, and they shot better than their percentages, and made big free throws and attacking plays. We hurt ourselves several times where we played good defense, and late in the shot clock, we fouled either the jump shot or the drive, and that's something that we've got to correct.
Chris, it seemed like when you came in the Wichita State game and the last few games you're a little rusty. Today you seem to have a good game. Is that just for you getting back in the rhythm of things after being out for so long?
Yeah, I mean 2 years is a long time. And plus, just getting back in the rhythm. It's my fifth game playing. I felt really comfortable out there today. I'll take it one game at a time.
Jarod, earlier this season it seemed like you were struggling a little bit, and today it seemed like you had your game back that you had last year, that you were so effective. Was there anything coming off the trip that you did, or is it just now we've gotten so far in the season, you're back into the flow of things a little bit?
Basically, when I got that time to go home, I just went home, looked at myself in the mirror, and just questioning myself a lot. And then I just keep working hard, and that's all I got to keep doing, just keep working hard, going there, pushing myself every day.
Jarod, did you feel any more comfortable, more so having that ball in your hand, the point guard spot? Maybe I know you're a combo, but you at the same time, you've always felt real comfortable having that ball in hand. So just playing a little bit more points today, you feel a little bit more comfortable?
Especially in transition. If I know I can push it, I'm going to try to get it up the floor and get it to the rim. So.
Coach, how impressed have you been with Chris's just, quick turnaround in the sense of, a little rusty, we're not surprised, we knew that was going to come, it's been 2 years, but how impressed have you been with him just in practice, seeing him work hard every day, and then now seeing that on the court?
Well, and you come by practice, Lauren, mm-hmm. I mean, his hard work, he's a committed player, mm-hmm. He's invested in his game, and, so he's going to be ready. We knew it was about a matter of time when you're playing hard and doing the things that he does. I mean, he runs, he jumps, he just, make hustle plays. And then that's when you kind of find your offensive rhythm, and that's what he's done. I think, as he said, he hadn't played in two and a half years, mm-hmm. And, it's a transition for him. And I think you can see what he's going to, bring to this basketball team. And, it came pretty quick tonight. I think also, you know, when you look at the competition, his first game playing against the 11th ranked team in the country, I mean, that's a big challenge. And not to mention, we played good competition. So the Rising League, you know, it's going to be good. Everyone's going to be fighting to defend their home court. Going to Wright State, it's going to be a war. We've had tremendous battles with them. And we're going to shift gears and get ready for Wright State tomorrow.
Coach, do you think that, you know, your length and your ability to go 12 deep is going to help you against, you know, Coach Donlin, where, you know, he plays that really tough defense, he wants to slow the game down. Do you think it's going to be a positive for you that you're able to push the tempo so much and do exactly what he doesn't want you to do?
Well, I think you got to be smart. I think one of the things we've learned on the road trip that you got to value the possession, you got to take care of the ball. You know, we had 14 turnovers. We're still trying to get that, you know, get that down. We got to get that down in the conference play where we get more opportunities. But I think it's going to start on the defensive end and rebounding. They play a lot of small ball and guards. I think with our roster, we can go deep into our roster and play a lot of guys.
Chris, Jarod, what's kind of just the mindset right now of this team? What are you guys kind of feeling? Like I said, heartbreaking loss obviously here, but just what are you guys feeling right now as far as going into Rice State as a locker room? What's that mindset and of this group right now?
There's really two things. One thing is, well, it's the second season. We're 0-0 right now in the Horizon League, and we're looking to get our first win on Friday. And, you know, we're still trying to look for our identity. You know, it's going to start tomorrow, practice again. We're going to play defense, we're going to rebound. Rebound has really been a big issue for us all year, but, you know, we're just going to keep working at it, we're going to get better. Like, we're going to be a better team. I feel confident in my teammates, my coaches. So we're just going to come in the Horizon League, we're going to get it done.
Well, basically what Chris said, like, this whole year we've been talking about threshold and like how we just going to push through the threshold. Like, you know, I just feel like this new season coming around, we 0-0 right now. So basically I just feel like we finally going to bust through and we going to show who we really are and show what we really can do, too.